Hi guys, I'm Chantelle and I blog over at intentionalhomeschooling.com, and today I wanted to talk about how I plan our homeschool year without a curriculum. Now, whenever people ask me about homeschooling, one of the main things they ask is like, does your school division like supply you with a curriculum? Like, how do you know what to teach? All those kinds of questions. People feel overwhelmed. They feel like they're gonna miss something. And yeah, so today I'm going to talk about how I plan our homeschool year without a curriculum. This last year, I did decide pretty much near the end of the year that we are officially switching to unschooling. But to me, that doesn't mean that we're not going to set goals and plan. I know that might seem counterintuitive, but planning and making goals are really important to me. My personality really revolves around making goals for myself. And I'm not always disappointed if I don't hit my goals, but I do feel like it's a way to push myself and make myself grow. And I feel like the same applies for homeschooling. I also feel like I can be a bit of a role model for my kids this way and help them to set goals for the school year and set goals with them. So a few years ago, I created a free printable on my website that was a broad homeschool goals. I think I had for pre-K or K all the way till grade 3. And that was incredibly popular. It made me realize how much people needed, you know, to have broad goals for their year, how much that resonated with people. And now that my daughter is going into grade 5 this next year, I feel like I should maybe make one for grade 4, 5, 6 as well, because that's kind of the stage we're getting into. So watch out for that. I will hopefully have that on the vlog in the next couple of weeks. Okay, so how do I go about planning our year? Now let me just start this off by saying what I do. Maybe this will help you. This is why I'm putting it up. I'm hoping it will help you, but this is not like the only way to do it. I know this way will not work for other people because it won't jive with their personality. I get that. I'm just going to share what I do, and then hopefully it will help some people out there. So the first thing I like to do every year is look back on our last year. And obviously if you haven't been homeschooling before, you can't do this, but if your kids have been in school, you can look at this. And I always write a list of things that worked well and things that didn't work well. And I usually put this on my blog. I haven't actually done that, put it up yet this year, but I should probably do that in the next couple weeks as well. But I know off the top of my head, one thing that worked really well for us this year was switching to unschooling. I mean, that was big. It took a weight off my shoulders. It helped us to follow our interests, and it just really worked much better for the personalities in our house. Now, something that didn't work well, and this one is not really like it didn't work well, but what we did this year is we started fostering. So we had 3 different kids come and go, and one kid has come and stayed during this last school year. And so it definitely changed things. And it has, for that reason, it's affected my decision to start unschooling, because we need to be flexible with our lives when we have kids coming and going, and we have family visits and we have doctor's appointments and all those different things. So that is just something I wouldn't really put it in and doesn't work well, but it definitely affected how we did things. And in the end, it actually affected it in a positive way. One of the things we did not do this year that I wish we would have done is poetry tea time. Now, sometimes in the years past, we have, you know, taken one day of the week. Usually it was Tuesdays after lunch, or sometimes Tuesdays before lunch. We would have a little snack and read some poems together. And I really liked this time because it helped broaden my kids' horizons, because poetry is not something kids normally pick up on their own. And it just gave us like a good family bonding time. And yeah, that's something I want to bring back for this next year. So when I'm planning for my next school year, I always look back at what worked, what didn't work, what we want to include. And for myself this year, those are some of the things on my list. Okay, so now if we're going to look forward and plan our school year, I have created a homeschool vision planner. It's totally free. I'll leave the link below. But what it is probably, well, it's a ton of different questions, maybe like close to 100 questions for you to ask yourself that will help figure out, you know, what your family values, why you want to homeschool, the different things you want to cover over the span of your kids' lives. And for me, now that I have like written that all out, that's kind of like my process of how I do it. Now that I have that all out, I actually go through a lot of the questions in there every year, and that helps guide our homeschool planning. One of the big things in the homeschool vision planner that I created is an individual interview with each child. And this is a lot of fun to do. So I go and I ask my kids like some of the things they want to learn this coming year, I ask them what they're good at, what they feel like they want to get better at, some books they want to read, that kind of thing. And I write it all down, and it's really nice because I keep the list from year to year. And it's incredibly interesting to see the same things for one of the kids like keep popping up every year, because that really shows you the things that they like keep their interest in. Like, so for my son, every year he says he wants to learn more about the human body. And I have no idea what he's gonna do as a career, but I am just so curious to see if that human body just keeps following him and he ends up doing something with it. So this individual interview is important to me because I like to follow my kids' interests for a school year, but even if you like to be more structured, I think it's really important to also include things you know your kids are going to be interested in. By using the information that I gathered in the interviews that I've done with my kids, I can create unit studies, or I can help them to create different things for them, like themselves to go off and research on, or I can create this year what I'm planning on actually doing is creating a schedule for my kids so that they read the books they want to read, that they can actually get all those books done throughout the year. So I'm like scheduling kind of like one book a month for them to read based on what they've told me that they actually want to read. So after I have done their individual interview, I like to sit down and write down some broad goals. Now, we have to register with our school division to homeschool, and our school division is pretty relaxed. They don't ask for a ton of things, but what they do ask for are three goals for language arts, for science, for math, and for social studies. So I don't know 100% if I would actually do this if I didn't have to every year, but I have to do it. So I create three different goals in each of those categories for each of my kids. I try to keep it broad so that if our interests change a little bit throughout the year, it can. But I think this has been really powerful for me. It helps me to sit down and think about, okay, what are the different things I want my kids to learn? What do I think they should be learning at this age? What are their interests? And what are the kinds of things that I want them to know by the end of this school year? So I take some time and I write out all those different goals. So that'll be three goals times four subjects for each kid. Then from there, the school division actually requires us to write down how we're going to test or prove that we've actually reached these goals. I don't really test my kids really at all, unless like once a year they ask for a spelling test and then they're like, yeah, let's do that again, and they never ask for it again. So I don't really test my kids. So for that one, I kind of just make things up. Like, you know, because as a parent, you'll kind of know if you hit those points or not just by watching them. You don't have 30 kids in your class, so you don't have to, you know, not be sure on what that kid is doing. So after I have our goals, what I like to do is kind of write myself reminders. So I might create a little bit of a reading schedule, like I mentioned, or let's say one of the interview questions I ask my kids is, are there any field trips that you want to go on this year? And let's say there's something that they want to do. Then I'll just set a reminder on my calendar to pop up. Maybe it's something we want to do in the winter or in the spring or whatever. So that will pop up and remind me to plan that. So one thing you'll notice here is I'm not planning a day-to-day schedule. What I'm doing is I'm trying to look at the broad picture. I'm trying to look at the end of the year. What do I want them to have gained? And what do they want to have gained from the year? And we're going off of that. I see my role like more of a facilitator, a person who finds them resources. If they want to learn about the human body, we go to the library when we can, and we take out all the books on the human body. You know, I want to help give them the resources that they need and to follow their interests and dive deeper. So I don't set a daily schedule because we don't, you know, do school every day. That's not how it looks in our house. But it might look like that in your home. That's fine. But I still think that following this general outline, you know, setting goals, having an interview with your kids, setting goals with them, all that comes together to create, you know, your own homeschool curriculum, your own personalized curriculum that will help each of your kids. So yeah, then throughout the school year, I just, you know, find resources. I often will like check in, like, okay, is there something you want to be learning about now? Like, we finished kind of following this topic through. What else do you want to learn about? Or, oh, hey, I found this resource I think you might like. That's kind of how I see my role for teaching my kids at home. So if you want to get a copy of the free homeschool vision planner and links to the blog posts, I'll have that all down below. So you can check that all out. And thanks for watching another video, guys. If there's something you would like to see a video on in the future, just leave a comment below and let me know.